Simmons finished with just 1.5 rebounds and 7 assists, turning the ball over 5 times and recording a team low minus 23 in the Philadelphia 76ers 108-103 to the Celtics, and put his poor showing on himself. "I think it was mainly what I did to myself," Simmons said of his career low-scoring effort. "I think, mentally, I was thinking too much, overthinking the plays. It wasn't just out there flowing. I didn't play the way I play, which is free. Obviously they have a game plan, I know what their game plan is, and I've gotta play my game." Simmons, who was benched for a significant portion of the fourth quarter, didn't make any field goals, marking the first time in his career that he's been held to just 0 made field goals. The Celtics used multiple defenders on Simmons, who will be hoping to rebound as his 76ers head back to Philadelphia for Game 3, trailing 2-0 in the Eastern Conference semifinals. Live stream the 2017-18 NBA playoffs on ESPN with the Foxtel Sports Pack. Get your free 2-week Foxtel Now trial. "It happens," Simmons said. "It's not the perfect timing, but you head home now. We've got 2 home games that we need to take care of and handle business. We've got the team to do it and the coaching staff, so we've just gotta go do it." The Celtics were led by their own rookie, with Jason Tatum posting 21 points in the impressive comeback victory. Terry Rozier continued his stellar postseason with 20 points, 7 rebounds, and 9 assists, while Al Horford posted 13 points, 12 rebounds, and 5 assists of his own. Australian center Aaron Baines finished with 5 points and 4 rebounds in the win. Redick led the way for the 76ers with 23 points, while Joel Embiid finished with 20 points, 14 rebounds, and 5 assists, for a team that led by as many as 22 points in the second quarter, before the home team quickly got back in the game. The Celtics began the game with Horford on Simmons, before throwing a mixture of Marcus Smart and Marcus Morris at the point guard. "I think the way Boston is guarding us in general is something that I respect," 76ers head coach Brett Brown said. "I've said that every time, pre or post game, I say the same thing. They are elite, guarding their own men. I think there's a physicality and a switchability that they get apples for apples on many different matchups." Philadelphia 76ers center Joel Embiid, 21, and guard Ben Simmons, 25, have words during a break. "Source, AP, with Ben, I give them credit. They do a good job defending him. There's an element of physicality I feel they have applied to all of us. Tonight, Ben struggled, as we see. I give Boston's defense a lot of credit and respect." In a turnaround from Game 1, the 76ers came out of the gates in rhythm, with Redick scoring the first 8 points of the game to force a Celtics timeout. The 76ers appeared to finally be making their shots from beyond the arc, Redick hitting a 3-pointer at the end of the first quarter to give his team a 31-20 lead. A dunk from Baines kept the Celtics' deficit to within single digits as the period came to end, but the momentum was all with the 76ers. That proved to be the case to start the second quarter, with TJ Connell and Robert Covington leading the way on both ends of the floor as the 76ers jumped out to their biggest lead of the game, a 48-26 advantage. With Simmons in the midst of a quiet game, the Celtics pounced, putting together a 25-8 run as the 76ers entered the main break with just a 56-51 lead. The third quarter began as a back-and-forth third quarter, with Brad Stevens' defensive schemes still making Simmons unable to find his rhythm. A Baines three-pointer gave the Celtics their first lead of the game, which quickly ballooned to 76-68 after a Tatum dunk. Embiid took over the scoring load for the 76ers as the period came to an end, with the Celtics leading 79-75, heading into the final quarter. Ben Simmons drives by Smart. Source, AFP. Back-to-back scores from McConnell, followed by a Covington three-pointer, saw the 76ers retake the lead, with both teams exchanging baskets until the midway point of the quarter, when Simmons finally checked back in. His team leading 93-91, a pair of Horford free throws tied the game at 93 apiece, before the Celtics put together another run, highlighted by a Tatum alley-oop dunk, to effectively seal the win. Brown made the decision to reinsert Simmons into the game, as the outing went down to the wire, despite the impressive play from McConnell. The 76ers' backup point guard finished with 8 points and 5 assists, while recording a team-high 16. "This whole playoff experience is something I want our young guys and star players to learn from and grow," Brown said of his decision to put Simmons back into the game. "The decision, do you go with TJ, still, or do you come back to Ben Simmons? I'm coming back to Ben Simmons, I'm coming back to Ben. He's had a hell of a year. I think he's the rookie of the year. I think he's gonna have to learn to play in these environments, and I'm going back to Ben Simmons. Game 3 is set for Sunday, AEST, and will be played in Philadelphia. Relive. If you can't see the blog, click